everyone, and welcome to another episode of Sincerely Alana. On today's episode, it's going to be a Preserving the Culture segment with Keti Veimau.
Hi.
I know Keti through the Veimau family, and they are the directors of Kalea Onalani, which is the studio that I dance with. And he's been dancing for a few months now, yeah?
Just since November. End of November, yeah.
So, two-ish months.
Yeah.
And he fits right in already. I'm not even dancing right now because I'm on a break, but everybody's like, oh my god, Keti, he's so good. You have to come see him. And we're just like, okay, I gotta meet Keti. Yeah. And your brother's here too, huh?
Yes. He's currently at the gym right now.
That's where I should be. So, Keti, can you just tell us a little bit about yourself and what you are, what you do?
Okay. Well, my full name is Peter Lo Keti Veimau. I'm 18 years old. I'm half Korean, half Tongan. I was born in California. And for the past 7 years, I've lived in Tonga. And that was very life-changing.
That's so cool. So, you have a lot of family in Tonga, right? So, everyone, I know, I'm like half my family I haven't even met, and they're all in Hawaii. So, can you just describe a little bit about what your life is like in Tonga and like how the family dynamic is out there?
Wow. Well, for one, man, how do I put this? It's just really different than life out here. Because, to be honest, when we're living out here, we're kind of like spoiled and we didn't appreciate what we had. So then going out there, it was like going from having everything to like having almost nothing. So it was very humbling and it helped us to appreciate what we have and the people that we have around us. And not like just saying that because everyone says that, but like really appreciating every little thing and the people and the things that people do for us.
Yeah, definitely. That's so cool. I feel like a lot of people need that. You know, we are definitely spoiled out here. So I'm half Hawaiian, half Mexican, and I went to see my dad's family in Mexico, and it was like we have all this, and like you said, like, there's basically nothing there. I know Tonga's like way different too. Mexico still has so much, but that's insane. So, what is your life like? I know you dance.
Yeah.
Yes. So, what's dancing like out there?
Dancing is hard out there. Okay, so like dancing out here is hard because you kind of have to make your name for yourself because there's so much dancing out here. But then dancing in Tonga is total opposite because there's no dancing in Tonga. Like we're the only dance crew out there that dances hip hop. Like there's the Tongan five on stuff, but nobody does hip hop. They used to have dancing before like 2010 to 15, but it died out. And so now like we're the only hip hop crew out there and trying to help create a platform for other people who want to dance. Because there are a lot of people who can dance and want to, but they don't have the right outlet. So that's what we're trying to create, is like the outlet for dancers.
That's cool. That's so cool. I love that. So like you said, he does hip hop dancing. Do you do any other dancing or are you like strictly hip hop?
Well, we try other styles, but since we all started in Tonga, like none of us have gone overseas and studied and tried other styles, so we kind of were all self-taught what we learn on YouTube and everything. But
oh, I love that.
But yeah, I just started the hula since I came out here, and I did hula once before with some Hawaiian friends back in Tonga, but this is totally different, like much harder. I'm loving it. It's like a new style to learn.
That's awesome. So, quickly, if you want to talk about that, why you did come back, and if you're here permanently, or if you're gonna go back home.
Well, I originally came out here just to work for a little while, because since we don't have much in Tonga, I was gonna be out here to like financially support my family back home and help pay off some stuff and get some stuff done. And I didn't want to come out here. Because, so like, I first went out to Tonga and I hated it and I wanted to come back. But then after being there for so long, like, I've really grown to loving it there. So I didn't want to come out here. So at first, it was just supposed to be until April. and go back, but now I'm like having second thoughts of staying out here. But yeah.
I mean, either way, you know, people would love to have you here. But I'm sure that I would love to go. I would love to see Tonga. I'd love to see Hawaii. I've still never been.
Oh wow.
Yeah.
I wanna go to Hawaii. That's nice.
From what I hear, I'm like, I wanna go. I wanna meet my family. Yeah, that's crazy. So preserving the culture. This is the second episode that we've done like this. The first one we did was with an artist named Kamaka Molin, and we talked about how he preserves the Hawaiian culture through music and through dance groups and being involved in the community. So what aspects of Tongan culture are your favorite, and how do you think you preserve the Tongan culture?
I think that would be the type of love and respect everyone's got out there. Like in the culture, there's like, we call it faka'apa'apa, and that's basically like respect. But there are certain like, I don't know, like rules, I guess you could call it, in the culture that like most families in Tonga like would uphold and apply to their family, like within the household. And going out there at first, it was really like weird, because we were so like balangi, like so American, that going out there, it was like really weird. But then after coming to understand it and like get the depth of why, like understand the deeper meaning of all that, it was like really,
I'm sure.
Yeah, I can't find the word for that.
It's intense. A lot of the people who I talk to, especially in Islander cultures, who have those like systems of respect and community, I feel like it's one thing to talk about it, but to experience it is completely different. Like everyone who I know has experienced it talks about it in such a spiritual way that it's like there really aren't words to describe it, for sure. That's amazing. Yep.
Shout out to our crew back in Tonga, Onion Squad. You can find us on Facebook or Instagram. Onion Squad on Facebook and Onion Squad Tonga on Instagram.
That's our episode for today. Follow sincerely Alana on Instagram, Facebook, and be sure to spread peace, love, and positivity. Follow.
Psycho, 100 in the Bible, Bible down, fight, go keep dance like Michael. My 2 minutes to the hall like a light bulb. Light bulb, hold on, I'm telling you the cycle.
My downfall,
yeah.
2 times for the homies in the chow hall,
whoa.
3 times for the on the internet, you know, when they really should get out more, 4 times for the days that were all bad, 5 times for the playing call back,
yeah.
6 times for the kids like me who got ADHD, just to get nabbing like ISIS,
whoa,
turn the whole world to a crisis,
whoa,
walk around the city with an ice pick, I've been paranoid, usually I ain't like this, ain't no telling how crazy I might get, beat the police with a nice stick, in my whole life I've been lifeless, now I'm so fly, I'm flight risk,
whoa,
a couple till I pass out,
whoa,
throwing stones in my glass house,
whoa,
I remember sleeping on my dad's couch,
whoa,
now I got the Bentley and it's blacked out,
whoa,
family looking at me like a cash cow,
whoa,
everybody dissing just a half clout,
whoa,
thought you had a chance, now you out,
man, where you at now,
whoa, now I'ma hit him till they jumpin', I ain't trippin', this is nothing. I've been living in the dungeon, I a couple grudges, got a jack to meet the devil, I'm a cousin, I ain't settling for nothing, got a medal in a truck, and keep a semi when the bus is ducking, even Stevie Wonder couldn't see it coming, I ain't judging, I just want the money, I don't need a budget, I've been hungry, I ain't got no oven, but I got the hundred. How you gonna move on the front line? If I'm with you, I just cut ties. My high school teacher said I'd never be, to that said I turned out just fine. And no, I don't know you for the 12th time. We do not share the same bloodline. You let it run your mouth like a tough guy. Hope you keep the same energy when it's crunch time.
Me and Jordan need a couple hearses. Double homicide, kill the beat and a versus. Everybody living on the surface, but we came from the underground. Yeah, we deserve it. What's beef? Beef is when you murder on the beat, kill them all, nah, nah. What's beef? Beef is brothers lying over that never mattered in the first place, lying in the street. What's